So we're going to be in 6:10. You know, of course, that sha'aruria is only used in one place. Okay, Bavet Yisrael Ra'iti, in the house of Israel, I have seen. All right, so we're going to Yirmiyahu Hey and see if we can figure this out. And we're going to read two verses, Shloshim and Shloshim Ve'echad. So this Shama is not like Shama like over there. It's got a dagesh in the mem. And so it's from that root shamam. Do you remember that? Okay, it's one of the sham words. Okay, we have lots and lots of sham words. Name, over there. And shum, garlic. Okay, nasham is to breathe. Okay, and so shamem is that that breath of astonishment. So these are the things that are happening in Jeremiah. There's an astonishment, and then there's this sha'arur, which is translated as horrible. Now this is a very nehyata. What can you make anything out of that? It is. It's a haya verb. So if it has a nun in front, what is it?
Nifal.
It happened. It was happened to. You can't translate it in English. Okay. Some astonishing and horrible thing has occurred in the land. Has befallen, taken place. So this kind of this tells you the things that have happened. And then we'll see why they're so horrible. It's not just enough to say, oh, it was a horrible thing. These are the horrible thing that happened. The Nevi'im, Nibuba Sheker, lies. They're prophesying lies, okay? That's bad. The Kohanim, year due from, yeah. Actually, there's a different root.
Oh, no.
Which is Radah, which is translated as to tread down. And you see it in Genesis, that the man will have dominion over the earth. So they are having, they're treading down, or they're having this dominion, how? Al yadehem, on their hands, by their own hand. They're treading down, they're ruling by their own hand. This is another horrible thing. So we have two horrible things. The prophets are prophesying lies, the priests are treading down by their own strength. And now, my people what? Ahavu ken. They love it like that. So even the people now have no discernment either. Okay, they're just perfectly happy living in this horribleness. And what will happen? Ma ta'asu, what?
They do.
What will you do? Acharit, what's acharit? In the end. What's going to happen in the end? What are you going to do in the end? If you love what's going on now, I guess you can get a little bit flavor of it because there's plenty of people in this country. Oh, great. We have same-sex marriage. We love it like that. Right? What's going to happen to the end to those people? It's not going to be pleasant. So we're back in Hosea, checking out. We've got this sha'arureha. This is this horribleness, this horrible thing that's going on. So Yahweh says, I have seen that in the house of Israel. This is the sham. That's the real sham. Over there, Zanut, you know. Right? The whole book is about Zanut, Ephraim, and that's a thought. Okay, and then Nitma Yisrael. What is Tameh? Defiled. Okay, what Binyan is it with the Nun? Nifa. Israel is defiled. 6:11. Gam. Aha Yehuda. Shat. We have several words that have the same idea. Seam and sheet is to place, to put in place. And so what is the short word, katsir? What is it?
Katsir. Is that the harvest
word? It's the harvest. Also for Judah. But this problem has been Beit Yisrael and Ephraim, but also for Judah. Shat, we can say it's like appointed. A harvest lach to you. So don't think you're getting away with anything, Judah. You know, we have this problem with Ephraim, yes, but you're not getting away with anything. There's a harvest appointed for you. Okay, so in returning, so this word, shavut, the root is shevi, and it means exile. So he's saying, when I return the exile of my people, there'll be a harvest when I return the exiles of my people. How do you think, can you relate this shev idea to exile? What is it? There's two easily confused verbs, right? Mm. Which one is the returning one? What's the root for returning?
Shoot.
So that's a hollow verb. So a lot of times we don't see the u, but that's return. What's the other easily confused verb here? Okay, to dwell. Okay, yeshev. Now, shevet, I mean, what does this root mean here? This root? Cease, that's right. We're going to have it here momentarily. Well, maybe it might not be today. the idea of returning Shuv to sit in the land Shev and ceasing Shabbat from your own work. Shevi is you're sitting, you're dwelling, but it's somewhere else. It's not where you belong. So he says, when I return the exile of my people, then there'll be a harvest. There'll be a harvest for good, a sheep harvest, and a goat harvest. All right, chapter 7, verse 1. So, like, or actually I think it is sort of more like when here. Raf'i. So we know Rafa, Rafa, to heal. And who was he going to heal? Israel. So just at the moment that he was going to heal Israel, what happened? Nigla avon Ephraim. So what is nigla? To expose.
It's a nephal.
This is a big nephal day. Okay, so how will you translate that? That's right. The iniquity, the avon, the iniquity of Ephraim was revealed, okay, in the passive sense. And what else happened? More than the iniquity of Ephraim, also the ra'ot of Shamron, the evils of Samaria. This happens very commonly, that you have a single verb with a single noun, and then an and an additional subject of the verb. You know, something like Vayidaber Moshe va'aharon, you know. And Moses said, and Aaron was Aaron, but he's not included in the verb. So these things are revealed. And what were they doing? Pa'alu, you know pa'al? Doing, working, sheker, lies. And here's the ganav, the thief, yavo, comes, pashat. It is a simple, plain meaning, but what is it? It comes from an action. Strip, take the clothes off. Coming, so it's actually there's two different thoughts. The thief is coming. Ganav yavo, you see the two dots above the bet, that's a little comma, and then another thing happens. Here's the verb, is the pashat, and the gadud, you know from last time. We did a lot of gadud last time. Troop. And so the troop is stripping, I think it's translated as taking booty. Okay, they're stripping all the other people. Bachutz, you know bachutz?
Outside.
Outside. You know, after a battle, there's a lot of dead bodies, and they go around, they take everything off the dead bodies, right, that they can take, whatever anybody has. So it's sort of like that. So just at the moment, he was going to heal them, but then he discovered all this abomination things going on. So I guess healing is not coming. Do you remember Val? It's one of those don't, Al is sort of like a command form. So it's very similar to Lo, they don't. They're not doing something. What are they not doing? They're not saying where? To themselves. Okay, they're not saying, taking note in their heart. They're not paying any attention in their heart. Kol ra'atam, all their evil, zacharti. I remember, right? God is saying, you don't even take note of the stuff you're doing. Okay, you don't even, it's not crossed your mind that I'm going to remember all this. So Baal comes from we have a few. We have Bli, which means without. And soon we might see Bala, which means to swallow. And there was one more thing I was thinking of. Bala can mean to wear out. I think when talks about their shoes didn't wear out, I think it uses this word. So the next part of the sentence is not so easy, but it's a bit in parallel. Savivum. Remember Savev? Should know it. It's coming up. Savev. It's a sivivon, a dreidel, because it's going around and around and around. Savev is going around. What's going around? Ma'alalehem, which we have touched on one time. There. So alal means is one of the words for work. Eventually we brought it down to children, but here we'll just say works, and we know here they're not good work because they're evil people. So all their works surround them. They're surrounded by their own works, which are no good. And where are they? Neged panai hayu. What about panai? My face, hayu, they were. They were. All these things. And where are they? Neged. Neged, means across from. So you have this phrase, Ezer Kenegdo. Where are we going to find that in Genesis? What's Ezer? Help. Kenegdo. This is Eve. She's a suitable helpmate. Is she across from him to beat him up? No, she's across from him, so she can see this 180, and he can see this 180, right? This is the meaning of neged. So neged has a verb, which is in the hefil. It's a drop letter. Lahagid, to speak. It's one of the words for speak. What's a Haggadah? It's the book that tells the story. Lahagid, it tells the story. It's more than just to speak. It's not just speak. It's to tell. So where does that come from? That comes from neged. That comes from the two people are should be talking face-to-face, not iPhone to iPhone. Their work surround them. They're down in the midst of this pit of evil things. And though all those things are across from the face of God, he sees it all. 7:3. Bara'atam. In their evils, what is happening? Samach.
They're happy.
Who is happy? The
happy.
King. Their evil doings are making the king happy. Shehem. And so what is the root of that? Chachash. It's also to lie. What's the other words for lie? Sheker is one. Kozev is another one. Okay, these are all words for lying. Lying is very important if you are a person who belongs to the God of the universe. Who's Bar Kokhba?
Yeah,
Akiva said he was the Messiah.
Yeah.
Okay, it was around 135 A.D. So what does his son mean? His name? Well, I gave that away. Bar is son. And what is Kochav? Star. Okay? But that wasn't his name. His name was Cosby. Akiva, what do they say? History is written by the winners, right? So Akiva was obviously well respected, but he had people said, no, this guy's not the Messiah, and his real name is Kozev, and he's really a liar. So that goes back into history. By their evils, they make the king rejoice. Their evils make the king rejoice, and by their lying, Sarim,
princes,
okay? So it's a parallel construction, okay? Their evils make the king rejoice, and their lying, we don't get to make the rejoice, the princes make the princes rejoice. Things are very bad here, not in the state of Denmark, but whatever state they're in the state of Ephraim. 7:4. Okay, all right, it's a lot of words we don't know here. All right, kulam mena'afim, we should know. Na'af, no'ef, we've had it at least a dozen times since the beginning. Adulterers, lotina. It's one of the commandments. Like, kamo, tanur. I don't know. Do we know tanur? It's an oven. Now, how can you remember that? Because if you eat Indian food, you know that there is a cognate, and that's a tandoori oven. So a tandoori oven is round and has a hole in it that you can put the things in. The bread, they just smack up on the side of the oven. Now, why would compare a no'ef, a philanderer of this sort, to an oven?
He's hot to trot.
He's burning. Bo'era, you should know from the song. So it's Yeshayahu, Samachbet, Pasuk HaRishon. If you're learning these songs, you should learn all the vocabulary from these songs. And that will multiply your vocabulary immensely. Here it is at the very end. You've R. Lema'an Zion, for the sake of Zion, lo echeshe. I will not be silent. Ulema'an Yerushalayim, lo eshkot. Sheket, sheket. Ad yetze, until yetze, going out. Now, no, God, I don't expect you to know, is a light. Tzidka, tzedek,
righteousness.
Okay, until her righteousness goes out. Noga, like a lamb. The Yeshuata, salvation. We had in the song yesterday, it also used the word Yeshuata. Okay, in Yeshuata lo. There's no salvation for him. Kalapid, this is the torch. Yivar, what is Bo'er? Burning. Bo'er is burn. It's even very a little bit close, okay? They're like an oven. And what is burning? Me'ofe. Let's see where there's baking going on in Bereshit Yud Tet. Who's baking what in Bereshit Yud Tet? Pasuk Shalosh. He entreated them. He pressured them a lot. Beyasuru.
They turned.
They turned aside, right? Towards him. Beyavo'u El Beto, you know. They came to his house. Beyas Lahem Mishteh. No, he made Lahem. For them, a mishteh, where you shoteh. It's a party, it's a feast, and that's where you shoteh. It's not necessarily a drinking party, but it's usually a happy party. But matzot afa, he make them matzah, and they ate. Was it Passover time? I don't know. Did they have Passover yet in Genesis 19? No. But what happened the next minute after all this?
They made an exodus.
They made an exodus. That's exactly right. So it's a shadow picture. It's a prefiguring of the exodus. If you eat matzah, the next thing that happens is you're going to leave. So that's one baking. Let's see another baking in Bereishit Mem. Pasuk HaRishon Vayehi. And it was Achar HaDvirim Ha'ela.
After these
things, Chatu, Chet. They missed the mark, they sinned. Who? The Mashke, the one who is Shoke, who's giving the drink, right, of the Melech Mitzrayim, and the Ofe, and the baker. Who did they offend? Adonihem, their master, who was Melech Mitzrayim. Okay? We're in the oven. It's burning. And we're back to Hosea. It's burning like a baker. Like a baker's oven. Here's your yishbot. Cease. Okay, it's from Shabbat. From Shabbat. Okay? All right, what is ceasing or not ceasing here? It's not from the city. It looks like from the city. It's not. It's from, like, ore. So we'll go to Shoftim. Hey. Pasuk Shtemesre. So this root, this Meir, is from this root, Ur, which means to awake. And usually, we actually see it more frequently in a hit pile, Hit O'Rare. Hit O'Rare means to wake up or to get up. Okay, good. Let's look at Shir HaShirim Dalin, Sheshesre. The problem is we don't want to confuse it with Ori, Kumi Ori, which means
shine.
Okay, so rising and shining. We say rise and shine. They go together. And they're cognates. Awake. Tzafon. What is Tzafon?
North.
He's talking about the north wind. Vo I teman. Boi. Boi. What do you want when you want a girl to come? You say boy, right? Boi. Teman. Where is the teman? Well, the other side was the north wind. So what do you think the teman is?
South.
Okay, it's a south wind, but it is the name of the country of Yemen. Where is Yemen compared to Jerusalem?
South.
It's south, okay? Negev is dry. It also is south, okay? Hafichi gani. Pach is to breathe. He breathed into him the spirit of life. Gan, gani, my garden. Yizlu b'samav, should be flowing with. Samim b'samim, spices. Spices are flowing. Yeah, it's also slang for drugs in modern Hebrew. Yavo, he will come. Dodi li, my beloved. Ligano, aviyochal, eat pri, megadav, the ones that he desires. Okay, or pleasant. Can we do one more verse on the Uri? Okay, one more verse on the Uri. Yishayahu memhe, pasuk shalosh esrei, anochi, I. Okay, so here's your word, ha-i-ro-te-hu. This is your Ur. It's in a hefiel form, and it means to raise up. Now we're getting close to the meaning. We're talking about an oven. It's not about the temperature. It's about what raises, right? What raises? The bread. Okay, I raised him up at Tzedek, v'chol drachav, all his ways ayasher, yashar, yashar. I made them straight. I made his ways straight. Hu yivneh iri. He will build my city. But Galut, what is Galut? Also an exile, Yeshaleach. He will send them out. He will send the people that are exiled in a different place. He'll send them out. Lo b'mchir, without price. Lo b'shachad, without a bribe, says Yahweh, Lord of hosts. So if we go back, we probably see that somebody is somebody's going to build a city. All right, we're just going to have to stop here in the middle of the verse and just leave the bread and the flour rising until next week. Shalom.